Very good afternoon to everybody. Respected Chairperson Dr. Jha, respected my co-speakers, organizers, especially Mehul sir, dignitaries, and my young and dynamic JIDA students. It's a very uncomfortable situation for me to stand here being a non-technical person to this auditorium, but I still dare to speak something which is very relevant to all of you in your day-to-day life and obviously to the nation development. I don't doubt that anybody in this auditorium will disagree to this sentence. Health certainly is not everything, but everything without health is nothing. And I hope none of you would like to sit in this international conference with loose motion or running nose or severe headache or a bout of cough. So these are our day-to-day elements which need to be taken care of if we really need to do something productive in our life, in our family, in our community, and ultimately to our nation building. And a healthy nation lies in a healthy community. But the problem is vicious cycle. If the health is poor, production goes down, and the growth again is poor, which means the revenue generation is low. Again, the country cannot put money to the healthcare system, and the cycle continues. But what I learned, and I think all of you will agree, that the consumer, which is the patient, has very little say in today's healthcare. So what I will highlight in this 15 minutes, the statistics, rural-urban divide, the healthcare ecosystem, which is the vital and the core point of my discussion, and challenges in each of the stakeholders. I have my proposed solutions, and we'll discuss something about the government initiatives. And definitely, I'll show you something for which I am standing here. Many things have been discussed in our previous sessions that we are doing well, but I'm pretty doubtful if anybody of you, and I hope many of you are from very rural areas, and you have been in touch with lives of the tribals, the scheduled castes, the BPL categories, and if you know their family standard, annual income, health expenditure, health status, education, you will never believe where we stand in this modern and developing India, where India is going to be one of the superpower. Our infant mortality rate is 40 per thousand. That means 40 children out of 1,000 births never see their first birthday. And around 20 children die before they complete 1 month. That is neonatal mortality rate. Life expectancy in the developing world is growing fast, and we are still below 70. In UK, it is 86. US, around like that. But still, we don't hope to live beyond 60. 50 ho gaya, are abhi to budhe ho gaye. So that is our attitude. Percentage of expenditure in healthcare is 5% only. And it's ridiculous to say only 1% comes from the government treasury, 4% goes from our own pocket. And we rank 130 in the World Bank ranking, the World WHO ranking, and the Human Development Index. This slide has already been discussed in our morning session. The rural-urban divide is now going to alter in around 2010 to 2020. But still, India is around 60-40, and Orissa, my native state, is around 80-20. If we discuss the healthcare ecosystem, there are four major role models we are revolving around the central person, who is the patient or the customer. The healthcare system, the hospitals, the doctors or the practitioners, insurance agencies, and the private drug manufacturers. So patients may be individual or the institutional. Corporate bodies, where if you are an employee, you are free of a headache. Anything goes wrong, the company will take care of your health. That doesn't happen to a villagers or me, maybe employees of JDAS. Government hospital, private hospital, and NGO-run hospitals, they are three major players in healthcare delivery system. I'll come individually, what is their role and of what challenges they face in day-to-day activities. Doctors, we have government and private, and insurance agencies, you may knowing public sector and private. And in drug manufacturing industry, they're almost 100% private. If we come to the rural healthcare system, where the center being in the patients or the common public, they are illiterate, cannot afford, unaware, and burdened with so many beliefs which we find very difficult to digest even after 70 years of independence. This is one such example that happened only 4-5 days back. Navarampur district, a newborn baby, 14 years, was struggling hard to take breath, and the mother took her to a black magician, and who started branding him with iron rod, and the baby died within a day or two after being taken care of to the district headquarters hospital. None of the doctors could save the life. And that's we develop as a superpower. There is a lot of difference between patients' need and the doctor's knowledge, because in many poorer part of our country, in developing states like Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Bihar, maybe in Madhya Pradesh, because there is a lot of language difference. Doctors are taught very advanced languages, and we fail to understand the local dialect. Hospitals. Presence is negligible, sparsely distributed. Many panchayats do not have first aid centers. That's how they go to the quacks and the black magicians. Even if there is a hospital in a rural village, they need lack of building, diagnostic equipments, skilled manpower, and availability of essential drugs. 18% of primary health centers lack skilled doctors. Now, the government has taken this initiative of equipping these hospitals with AYUSH doctors, which is a very good initiative. But again, there is a big problem in implementing this scheme. Though this is a very wonderful scheme, these doctors neither have the supply of the medicines in which they are trained. They are forced to write allopathic medicines which they do not know. Even if the doctors are there, they are also not skilled with up-to-date knowledge, and the recent developments with medical ethics and the all-round development. So in the challenges and rural healthcare, there is also a pay disparity between private doctors and the government doctors. And recently I saw the newspaper, some 800 or 900 doctors, they started marching in the streets of New Delhi yesterday with begging bowls, because they have not been paid for salary for months. And there are always influence from external politicians and local leaders in the healthcare delivery that prevents doctor to remain in far-flung areas. Insurance agencies, there is lack of distribution of these agencies. In the rural, and people cannot afford, even if they know, they don't understand the utility of insurance. So that is also not applicable to rural healthcare. Only one scheme which has very recently come to practice is this scheme, Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana, RSBY, but it has miserably failed, because the beneficiary are unaware of the benefits. Insurance companies are not taking enough interest to empower them, and also there are lack of supportive hospitals where they can avail the facilities. Drug manufacturers, even if there is scope of cheaper drugs available, they exploit the customers and the beneficiaries, and because they are poor and with lack of knowledge, they don't know what to do. Even if there is supply of cheaper drugs, this government supply, the government program of Janaushadhi, which is very generic provision of generic drugs, it's there, but because of the monopoly of the pharmaceutical agencies, it is not coming to the hands of the beneficiary. But today, this is paper cutting from today. I got it from here only. This is very deadly disease coming, just like Ebola. This is Zika virus. And fortunately, some of our Indian doctors in Hyderabad have succeeded in developing a vaccine first time in the world. Some of my solutions are, lot of corporate and CSR funding is needed for infrastructure development, NGO-based model to develop healthcare system in the rural areas, telemedicine and IVR system that has already been experimented and has shown results in African countries, and short duration courses like MBBS with the aim to work in the rural communities. And this is one innovative thing I want to share, is tax deductible medical savings account, just like ESI or PF, if applicable, may help the rural poor. IT enabled solutions and e-learning for doctors posted in rural areas. And certainly, lessons on ethics and national building, lessons to be taught to the medical graduates while coming out of the school. Maybe this is one of the paper cutting from today. Doctoron ki retirement umr ho sakti hai 70 saal. This is one of the proposals coming from CM of Madhya Pradesh. The government has started this national health mission under two schemes, urban health mission and rural health mission. And rural health mission is entirely dedicated for the upliftment of the rural public, but implementation is having some deadlock, and we need to improve on that. What we do, I am an eye surgeon and I am tackling with burden of blindness in the rural community, and I am an eye surgeon and doing lot of cataract refractive error, and that is defective vision, and glaucoma, which is a very sight destroying disease and irreversible.
What dreams would he have not seeing?
Please watch this 4-minute video.
Where is the justice being born that way?
With few like-minded people, I started this initiative of establishing rural eye health care in western part of Orissa, though I don't belong to that area. I belong to coastal belt. And with this small team, I started the hospital. These are not the late day laborers, they are my paramedics, and which has grown to a number of around 50 and 3 hospitals in the tribal belt. And now we are the major players in eye care in Orissa. And we have attracted almost 3 dozens of established and reputed consultants from across the globe to come to our town to extend their skills and train our paramedics, our doctors, and in return they are also getting some hands-on training to upgrade their skills.
This is Betty's ashram, located in the open, idyllic countryside a few miles from the town of Sambalpur. Patients are brought in from various villages as far as 150 kilometers away. These people come from the poorest background imaginable. To top that off, most have been blind due to cataract for years and unable to therefore conduct basic activities for livelihood. This place, Dr. Shiva Prasad Sahu's Trilochan Netralaya, offers them a sign of hope.
I was born in a very poor background and given the opportunity to study in a school called Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, where I did 7 years of study, free everything, starting from soup, police, to hair dye, to book and to magazine, everything. I said I must pay back my society, and when I was in BSS Medical College Bulla doing my residency in ophthalmology, I found a lot of people going blind in western Orissa because there is no facility available, and even if there is a facility available, there is no trained and skilled manpower. So I thought I must do something. I trained myself in ophthalmology and skilled myself to do huge number of cataract surgeries, what I am doing, and I feel proud of this.
Dr. Shiva started Trilochan Netralaya to provide free eye care to the needy in Orissa.
Because the cataract backlog in western part of Orissa is huge, I started this charitable eye hospital in the heart of Sambalpur, and now it has got 3 branches, one in the most western part of Orissa called Kolahandi district, and in the east in the Jagatsinghpur district. At present we are doing almost 12,000 to 13,000 cataract surgeries in a year in the 3 branches, and by the year 2020, would be able to cure all the backlog swiftly.
With our small initiative, though it was a very small team, we have succeeded in inviting corporate leaders and many more leaders, political, apolitical, to come to our hospital, and in the way adding value to the lives of those people who do have nothing. these are some of our awards and recognitions. And just to inform you, I am not confined to Orissa only. I have been with my team to this state, Chindwara, Khandwa, and where we have already performed mind-boggling numbers of surgeries, and we have received so many recognitions from the district collectors of these two districts in last 2 years. These are our figures, but still, yesterday this was one of my patients, bilaterally blind, means blind in both eye for last 6 years. So I all the time I believe, never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, this is the only thing that ever has. Thank you.